Trainz, a new era, and newer versions of Trainz use PBR Material Texture Sets. PBR Material Texture Sets can be downloaded from the internet for free. The three websites I use most are AmbientCG.com, Polyhaven.com, and Textures.com. With Textures.com, you need to create an account and a password to access the PBR Material Texture Sets. Where possible, I prefer to download 1024 by 1024 pixels in PNG format. For importing into Trainz, you can use either PNG or TGA format. However, files must be a power of 2, that is, 512 by 512, or 2 to the 8th, 1024 by 1024, 2 to the 9th, or 2048 by 2048, 2 to the 10th. Files can be adjusted in GIMP by selecting the Image menu, then Scale Image, and entering the power of 2 desired. Then selecting File menu, Export As, and choosing the file format by selecting Select File Type by Extension. PBR Material Texture Sets can have up to 7 texture maps: Base Color, Normal, Displacement, Emission, Roughness, Ambient Occlusion, and Metallic. But not all may be present in any given set. Emission is usually missing, as most materials do not emit light. A black map can be added for non-emissive and non-metallic, if they are missing. And a white map can be added for no ambient occlusion, if it is missing. For Trainz assets, often it is sufficient to use just 3 or 4 maps: Diffuse, Normal, and Roughness, and Metallic if the material is metal. The maps need to be either PNG or TGA format to be imported into Trainz, and the names need to end in Diffuse or Albedo, Normal, Roughness or Parameters, and Metallic. The Diffuse map contains the color information. The Normal map contains information on the degree of smoothness or roughness. The Roughness map contains information on the degree of matte or shininess. And the Metallic map contains information on whether the material is metal or not. Let's add a metal PBR material texture set to the UV sphere primitive. All primitives have a UV map assigned, so you can switch to the shader workspace to start texturing. The shader workspace has the 3D editor window you saw in the layout workspace divided into 2. On the right is a 3D editor window, and on the left is a shader window. To start texturing, you first create a material. After selecting the mesh, in the properties window, you select the Material tab, then select New. When you create a material, 2 nodes are added to the shader window. Nodes are boxes that transform inputs using computer routines to yield new outputs. Nodes are connected by lines called noodles to form what is called a node tree. The node on the left is called the principled BDSF shader node. It has several inputs, but only one output, that feeds via noodle into the node on the right, which is called the material output. The information generated in the principled BDSF shader node is fed into the surfaced input of the material node and determines the appearance of the model's surface, in this case, the UV sphere. To add a texture to the node tree, you add an image texture node. In the shader window, you select the Add menu, then Texture, then Image Texture. This node is a container into which you can add the information contained in a texture map. To the first Image Texture node, you add the diffuse map by selecting Open, locating the Metal Diffuse map, and loading. Connecting a noodle to the base color input of the principled BDSF shader node adds color to the UV sphere. An image texture node needs to be added for each texture map we want to connect to the principled BDSF shader node. Selecting the Add menu, then Texture, and then Image Texture, then adding the metallic map and connecting the output to the metallic input of the principal BDSF shader node adds the metallic information. This information is non-color, so the color space needs to be changed from sRGB to non-color. Selecting the Add menu, then Texture, and then Image Texture, then adding the Roughness map, and connecting the output to the Roughness input of the principled BDSF shader node, adds the roughness information. Again, this information is non-color, so the color space needs to be changed from sRGB to non-color. Selecting the Add menu, then Texture, and then Image Texture, then adding the Normal map, and connecting the output to the normal input of the BDSF shader node, adds the normal information. Again, this information is non-color, so the color space needs to be changed from sRGB to non-color. The normal map information also needs to be run through another node, the normal map node. Selecting the Add menu, then Vector, then Normal map, adds a normal map node. When dragged over the noodle connecting the normal image information to the principal BDSF shader, it will be inserted between the two. Adjusting the strength of the normal map adjusts the degree of roughness. Usually a value of about 2.5 is ideal. The UV sphere in the 3D editor window now has all of the information contained in the four texture maps of the battered steel PBR material texture set that we set out to apply. One final note. The setup as it exists cannot be imported into Trainz for two reasons. First, the material has to have a name that is compatible with Trainz, usually material.m.pbrmetal. Second, the metallic map needs to be combined with the roughness map and fed into the principal BDSF shader node through the roughness input. This requirement can be achieved with the Blender add-on PBR Painter. Also, if you are applying a non-metallic material, such as a plastic material, and use just the diffuse, roughness, and normal maps, you can import the textured mesh into Trainz.